So today we're going to talk about how to rid kidney stones with lemons, okay? We're getting a lot of requests from people that want to know, what am I going to do with my kidney stone? Is there some remedies? And so I'm going to just create this one video to summarize the latest information. Most of the kidney stones that develop are calcium oxalate stones, 59%, okay? 10% are calcium phosphate stones. 17% are uric acid stones, okay? So we're going to be focusing on the oxalates right now. So what happens when the oxalates combine with the calcium in the kidney, they can form these razor sharp little crystals that not only irritate your kidney, but they can irritate your joints and other tissues as well. What causes kidney stones? Now, there are several things that increase the risk of getting a kidney stone. Decreased urine volume, not consuming enough fluids, okay? You're dehydrated. Increase oxalates in the body. Oxalates come from the food and your body makes oxalates, okay? Part of the defense mechanism is to create these oxalates, which inhibit the consumption of that plant. So it's a kind of a survival mechanism. When we increase the consumption of certain foods with oxalates, it can start building up and creating problems. So you'd want to make sure that your oxalates in your diet don't exceed 50 milligrams per day. An average person consumes about 200 or more milligrams. What I did is I created this food chart from high to low based on one cup. Okay, and I also have the spices in here. And at the top of the list, you know what has the most oxalates? Parsley. Then we have rhubarb, spinach, radish, garlic, mixed nuts, rice bran, peanuts, beets. So anyway, if you want this list, I put a link down below. You can check this out. You can consume a little bit of calcium citrate with the meal to minimize the dietary oxalates. Not a lot, just a little bit, maybe one tablet. Or consume some goat or sheep cheese, because the calcium will combine with the oxalate in the digestive system and go through the body and not be absorbed as much into the blood and through the kidney. Okay, so this is just a little tip right here. So what increases the risk for getting a kidney stone is decreased urine volume, high oxalates in the body, too acidic. Your urine is a little too acidic. Increase blood calcium, and low citrates. A citrate is a compound that can either come from your body, can make it from certain metabolic pathways, or it can come from foods, okay, certain foods. When you have low citrates, your risk of kidney stones go up significantly. Now, if you look up the definition of low citrates through the body, there's two definitions, okay? It says total excretion of less than 320 milligrams. Another definition said less than 500 milligrams. I don't know which one it is, but it's somewhere probably in the middle. So you're just not producing or getting enough citrates, and these oxalate stones are forming. So citrates do three things. They inhibit the formation of stones. They help dissolve stones, and they also inhibit the stickiness of the calcium oxalate to the kidney tissue itself, allowing the stone to go through the body without sticking. Okay, so now here is the perfect remedy for kidney stones. Lemon juice, okay? Why? Because lemon juice has the highest concentrate of citrates out of any food. It also helps to alkalize the body. Even though lemons have citric acid, they turn alkaline after they're burned in the body, okay? Now, can you use lime? Absolutely. You can use lemon or lime. Doesn't make a difference. And lemons are low calcium, and they have very low amounts of fructose, because fructose can also increase the risk of getting kidney stones and especially uric acid stones. Now, why can't we use cranberry juice? I mean, you've probably heard that cranberry juice is good for the kidney. Well, cranberry juice is good, might be good for the kidney, but it's not necessarily good to dissolve stones, okay? Can't we use grapefruit, because that has citrate? Well, grapefruit does have citric acid, not as much as lemon. It does help dissolve calcium oxalate stones, but lemon dissolves the calcium oxalate stones and the calcium phosphate stones, and it also can help decrease uric acid stones, okay? So that's why we use lemon. All right, guys, so here's what you're gonna do. In the morning, You're going to drink 1 cup of lemon juice, okay? Don't add any water, just drink it straight. You can drink it with a straw or just drink it down, and then you can chase it down with a little water to clean out the teeth. Now, also take 1 cup of lemon juice and mix it with 10 cups of water, and you're going to be using that to drink through the day. What you're trying to do is keep your citrates very, very high in the body so we don't form any stones and so we start dissolving stones. And by the way, guys, any remedies that I recommend, check with your doctor first. If you're on some type of medical program, work with your doctor to see if you could do it. And all my recommendations are not meant to replace your medical care or cure you of any diseases, okay? So that's my disclaimer on that. A couple questions are going to come up. Can I use lemon juice from a jar or fresh lemons? Both of those options will work. The fresh lemon gives some extra benefit of more vitamin C. And usually when you have a kidney stone, you have inflammation, so that vitamin C is helpful. Now, as far as the topic of vitamin C, there's some conflicting data on vitamin C with kidney stones. There's some studies that will say that taking vitamin C will increase your risk of getting stones. Others will say it'll decrease it. But these studies were done on synthetic vitamin C, not on the vitamin C from lemons or not on the vitamin C from foods. So you don't really have to worry about that worsening things. It's just going to help things a little bit if you can do actual lemons, but it's a little more expensive. So I recommend either organic lemon juice. I mean, the ideal lemon juice would be the Volcano lemon juice. It's from Italy. They have the best, but you can use any lemon juice. All right. And one last point, when you're drinking this lemon water through the day, use a straw. That works better than exposing it to your teeth. Anyway, so I hope this is helpful. And again, if you want to download this chart, I put a link down below. All right, guys, thanks for watching. So if you're enjoying this content, go ahead and share it with someone that could really benefit from it.